Hi, Discourse Lovers. Just wanted to talk about the discus disease that I'm trying to have a fight with. Well, the discus diseases are pretty tough to deal with. But every so often it happens that, you know, they get sick. So this one actually started going in the corner, and he was eating, but not like a great eater, but it was going and standing in the corner right from this tank, like now the water stream going on. So there was some bullying also happening. I think some of the fish was bullying him quite a bit. So he was standing in the corner, started getting dark. It was very dark actually about 3 days back. The whole body was a little darker than what you see. I mean, still it is darker, but it was much more darker. I think that's when it gets to that point, I think it's a word of caution that, hey, we need to take care of it right away. So put him in this tank. It's a 10-gallon tank. Just use it for as an hospital tank, a quarantine tank for any of this once in a while issue with this fish. So started, first of all, the treatment started with Epsom salt. So it's 1 teaspoon per gallon is what they suggest, and this is like 10 gallon. So generally I just do half the dose, and I don't do full dose. And most of the time it has worked, but sometimes it has not. I have lost some discus. Maybe it was too late, or it was like pretty much my dosage was low. But putting in too much medication, it's not also not good for the fish. So I just take the halfway approach. So here, I just did like about 5 teaspoons for a 10-gallon tank of Epsom salt. So it was not getting better. So the next step, after a day, I started with Metro. So Metro is, I think it is 1 gram for every 20 gallons is what the calculation is. So here I did about 0.5 gram. Of that medication, just right directly straight into the water. So started that one, and this is the fourth day actually. So it has started getting better. The blackness has gone. So if it doesn't work, if the step that I do is I go and take a little bit more powerful medication. That's either the oxy tetracycline or the furin 2 is my next bet. That I try, and generally for this kind of a situation it works. So the water change I do once every day. I do 50% of water change, and there is no carbon in the filters. I have 2 filters running, one hang on the back and one the sponge. So that's my, and also there is a lot of aeration that we have to give, and the temperature of this tank is almost about 90. So that's pretty much it for this video. If you like it, to subscribe, and then until the next video, bye.